It's fair to say that Copenhagen did not deliver the full agreement that the world needs to address the collective climate change challenge. And that actually just makes the task at hand more urgent. And it means that the window of opportunity that we have to come to grips with this issue is closing faster than it was before. But although Copenhagen was not a complete success, it did produce three key outcomes. First of all, it has raised the climate change challenge to the highest level of government, which is ultimately the only level at which it can be resolved. Secondly, the Copenhagen Accord reflects a political consensus on the long-term global response to climate change that is needed. And third, negotiations a little bit more away from the cameras brought an almost full set of decisions to implement rapid climate change action near to completion. Now governments need time to digest what has happened, but cool heads already see these outcomes as a way forward to grasp a bigger and collective goal. So in a way you could say Copenhagen didn't produce the final cake, but it left countries with all the right ingredients to bake a new one in Mexico. As you know, the Copenhagen Accord was crafted by a group of countries, the biggest, the smallest, the richest, and the poorest. It represents a political letter of intent that first offers to reduce national emissions and sets a global temperature rise limit of 2 degrees centigrade. Secondly, defines amount of short and long-term finance to implement climate change action in developing nations. And third, sets 2015 as a review year to check if global action by then needs to be more urgent to meet the challenge. As you know, the accord language is anchored in the Climate Change Convention, and countries are telling me it should be used now as a way to reinvigorate the negotiations and make further progress. A great success before Copenhagen was that many countries pledged midterm reductions in emissions, and the world can expect them to honor those pledges. And now they have the opportunity to record those pledges in the Copenhagen Accord. Also at Copenhagen, negotiators came close to decisions on a set of measures which would make a long-term global response to climate change operational. We're now in a cooling off period that gives useful time and needed time for countries to resume their discussions with each other. If countries follow Copenhagen's outcomes calmly, with their eyes firmly fixed on the advantage of collective action, they have every chance of completing the job.